All right, let's lunch rush it here, and maybe we'll play that AJ a little bit later on. AJ had a good rant about what you just said, their continued development, their long and distinguished history of failing to really develop anybody, minus a few players here and there. All right, Adam, what's going on?
All right, I want to start in the NFL. The draft is 9 days away, and today Washington is meeting with Drake May, Jaden Daniels, and J.J. McCarthy all at the same time.
Is that weird?
That's what I'm asking you guys. According to Ian Rappaport, they're all there to meet with the brass again, coaches, everything. They're staying overnight. Not at the facility, obviously, but
it might be.
They're going to be doing more things tomorrow as well. And then Albert Breer also says that Washington and New England have had the four QBs, Jaden Daniels, Drake May, J.J. McCarthy, and also Michael Penix in for visits. And it seems like that Michael Penix is moving up draft boards.
Wow, really?
Yes.
Is that odd that three guys would be with the same team on the same day, Jurko? That seems odd to me that Washington's doing it that way. I mean,
maybe they're doing it for expediency.
Or just to put the three of them to the test and see who looks the best. I don't know, man. Talk about putting those guys in a maybe somewhat uncomfortable position. That seemed odd. I don't know how common of a practice that is. I can't recall hearing that too often, but I won't.
It is Washington.
Yeah, it's Washington. I can't. But they've got new ownership. They've got new people now. It's supposed to be different and better,
still
I thought.
Washington.
It's still Washington. Yeah, it seemed odd to me. I was very surprised to read it earlier. I was like, oh, I did a double take. I'm like, I don't know if that's the way I would handle it, but who knows? Maybe they'll get it right this time in Washington, too. They're like the Bears. They haven't really gotten it right in a long time. Think about that. Go take a look at their quarterback history. At least they got a guy who could throw for 4,000 yards. But
it's because he threw it 1,000 times.
That's true.
So we mentioned it a little bit early on with a caller. The Chicago Sky drafted Kamilla, Cardoso, Angel Reese, and Brianna Maxwell. The ESPN grade gave them an A for this draft, getting two former champions,
yeah,
and Brianna Maxwell as well. It's a pretty good night for the Chicago Sky.
It sure seems like it when I saw that's what they came away with. Plus, you know, Angel Reese, I think, pretty marketable too, isn't she? I mean, that's good for them. That seems like a good night for them, all things
sure
considered.
There's a lot of people crying about what her salaries are for the first 4 years.
Who, Caitlin?
Caitlin Clark, yeah. What she signed. Obviously, she's got sponsorship that's going to be coming with her, so she'll be making a lot more than that.
She'll crush it.
For anybody that wants to cry, ask yourself this question. How many games have you gone to? How many games have you watched? And if the answer is 0 and 0, then get off your keister and go to a game and then tune the channel in when they're playing and watch. And guess what will happen miraculously? More fans will attend the game, more people will watch, better contracts will be signed, and everybody will be a lot more happier.
Yeah, let's face it, it's tied to It's tied to revenue.
Of course.
So if you're upset about it, do something about it.
Right.
You do something about it by attending and spending money.
By going to the games. And by buying the merchandise, by watching the things so they can charge more money because there's more people watching.
And if you do those things, like Jurko's saying, then you have to find a way somehow to continue to spread the word and convince your friends and everything else to increase the revenue, because that's what it's directly tied to. Yeah, but I thought that was it seemed like a good night for them, for the Sky. A couple of very marketable stars, like you said, two women that have won each of the last 2 years on the championship team. So good pedigree, good stuff. Some size, some rebounding, it's good. What else, Adam?
Jeremy Fowler talked to a bunch of executives and scouts and put the quarterbacks in the draft into tiers. Tier one, there is one quarterback. His name is Caleb Williams. The most frequent scout / exec comp was Aaron Rodgers.
Ooh, not Mahomes.
No.
He likes to talk about Aaron Rodgers more, doesn't he? Hasn't he said how much he appreciated watching Aaron Rodgers growing up?
He says that's his favorite quarterback.
That's his favorite, right?
His favorite quarterback is Aaron Rodgers.
Okay. I'll take that. If it looks anything like Aaron Rodgers, the Bears will finally have done it. They will finally have done it.
Let's hope.
Mm-hmm.
You can only hope. That's all
if
you can
do. If he looks anything like it, I would take three quarters. I might take a half.
The other ones, Jaden Daniels did not have a comp. He's in tier two. Drake May is also in tier two. His most comp was Josh Allen with less arm strength or Carson Wentz.
Ooh, boy, that's a big
Carson
spread there.
Carson's first year was rookie of the year until the knee injury.
No, it was MVP. Second or third year. It was MVP
there
until
you
the
go.
Knee
MVP.
Tier terrific. Two and a half, which is
two
weird.
Two and a half.
Is J.J. McCarthy by himself. His comp is a mix of Kirk Cousins and Brock Purdy. And tier number three is Michael Penix Jr. and Bo Nix.
Okay. Any comps?
Bo Nix was Andy Dalton and Jimmy Garoppolo.
Andy Dalton and Jimmy
Garoppolo. Michael Penix Jr. was Tua Tagovailoa and Jordan Love.
Okay.
Tua with a better arm is what they said.
Tua with a better arm.
Yeah.
That makes sense. You could do a lot worse than Jimmy G and Andy Dalton, too. Just saying. I mean, if you're drafting a guy later, you could do a lot worse than that. Okay, what else, Adam?
The Bucks are going to be without Giannis Antetokounmpo through the beginning part of their series against the Pacers, according to Adrian Wojnarowski. They are hopeful the treatment on his left calf strain will allow him to return sometime later in the series. The price for the Bucks to win the series went from around minus 160 to minus 125.
Well, I thought it might even drop more than that.
Since Doc Rivers has gotten there.
They're below 500, aren't they?
Yep.
Were they a game below, I think, with
17 Doc? 17 and 18.
Is that what it was yet?
Yeah. They lost 3 out of 4 games to the Pacers this year.
Does it not bode well for Milwaukee?
It does not. And if they go out again because Giannis is injured, if they go out in the first round again like they did last year, boy, it's not going to be pleasant up in Milwaukee.
With Giannis healthy, they haven't played well.
Yeah, that's a good point, Chris.
Since they switched coaches and brought Doc Rivers in, they've been a struggling team.
They've been a 500 team, right? And I guess some of the defensive things were fixed. They kind of reverted back to playing more the way Brooke Lopez wants to play, and I think it got a little bit better. If you looked at the numbers, I think it got a little bit better. But, yeah, they were basically a 500 or just below 500 team. So even with Giannis, I think that's a fair point. Like, they seemingly have some trouble. They should be better with Brooke Lopez, with Dame, with Giannis. Those pieces haven't come together the way they thought. They should be better. They should be able to push Boston more if he were healthy. And I'm not sure even if he's healthy if that's the case.